So, you know, as I said, that most of us look at climate change as something distant. Barely about a week ago, there was a headline story in one of the biggest newspapers in this country, which said that Delhi was going to run out of water in just a two-year framework, you know, by 2020. And yet, people are just not waking up to it. You've given us wonderful literature, you know, tracking the movement of people and of geographies and societies. What finally got you interested in climate change and to write about climate change? And what do you think will make all of us wake up to it?
Well, I became interested in climate change around 20 years ago when I started writing one of my books. It's called The Hungry Tide, and it's set in the Sundarbans. And I did research for it there. And while I was doing this research, it became very clear that this area, this incredibly important ecological region, had been very powerfully affected already then by climate change. You could see the effects of sea level rise, you could see the effects of saltwater intrusion, and now I see the effects everywhere. You know, this, for example, mass migration has already started in the Sundarbans. In Western India, in Goa, for example, the entire working class now is actually from Bengal, and a lot of them are from the Sundarban.
So you
see this accelerating all the time. You see millions of people leaving already. I think we are facing a catastrophe that we simply cannot even imagine. And the example that you gave of Delhi running out of water, it is the most imminent of catastrophes. And yet, as you can see, when you go around Delhi, people are watering their plants, they're watering their lawns as if with no thought for tomorrow.
So, you know, Amitav, one of the theses in Amitav's book is that this is not just a scientific phenomenon, not just an economic phenomenon, but a complete failure of the imagination and of our culture. And I'm going to come and ask you that question, Amitav, what do you mean by that? But before that, very quickly, because we're not going to have much time, you had a very personal experience back in 1978 when you got caught in a tornado. Can you tell us why that affected you so deeply? And, you know, you seem to have come in contact with something mysterious and alive. Explain that phenomenon to us.
Yes, that actually happened in Delhi. I was in university then in 1978. And, you know, one day I was in the library and I was just walking down the street and, you know, in the university. And suddenly out of the sky, there appeared this tornado. And I had the quick wits to actually take shelter. I think if it was today, I would probably have stopped to take a selfie, you know, with this tornado coming down. And actually, many, many people were killed by this tornado. You know, the entire university was devastated by it. And then, of course, people forgot about it. But it stayed very much in my mind, because being inside that tornado was a kind of an uncanny experience. And I think this is one of the effects of climate change, that, you know, these uncanny events are sort of unfolding all around us now.
So, you know, you spoke about the fact that you seem to have come in touch with something alive, you know, that it's not just nature is inanimate, but we seem to have triggered something where it's actually a force coming back at us, you know. You've talked a lot about how it's a failure of the imagination and of culture, that climate change has not seeped into novels, into literature, and so it's not part of everyone's world in any way. Why is that? And why is that making you so worried?
See, I wouldn't say that it's a failure of all imagination. I mean, we know that in Indian literature in the past, or in many literatures everywhere, even in Western literature in the past, there was a very active reckoning with the Earth's atmosphere. In our epics, for example, in the Mahabharata, the Ramayana, they're filled with climate events. There's a personification of climate. It's really only within the modern era, since the 19th century, that we've started to think of nature, we've started to think of the earth as something inert, as something that has no power to act. And now this is what we suddenly discover. We thought the earth was dead, but the earth is not dead. And it is striking back at us in the most terrifying ways. And you know, the earth doesn't care about us. The earth is completely indifferent to our being here or not. Even after we are gone, the earth will be here. You know, many other creatures will be here. So we are really courting our own extinction.